Into this afternoon's game, 3 points out of first place in the Eastern Conference. The Rangers are not playing today, so the Bruins will have played one more than the Rangers coming out of this afternoon. Today's starting goaltenders brought to you by Taco Bell. Marc-Andre Fleury, perfect in terms of the one lost record in his last 8 starts, but he's obviously getting a lot of goal support because his goals against average is higher than 2.25 in that span. Tim Thomas, plain and simple, stole the game for the Bruins back on December 5th in Pittsburgh. The Bees got heavily outplayed in the third period and for much of the second as well, as Pittsburgh turned it up a notch and the Bruins had a heck of a time getting the puck out of their back third of the ice. It'll be strength against strength. Two of the very best lines in the NHL to start this one. Bergeron, Seguin, and Marchand against Malkin, Neal, and Kunitz. The game is on. This is going to be a dandy, Brick.
Yeah, high expectations, given the way the Bruins have had kind of lackluster efforts over the last 9 or 10. And Pittsburgh, as you pointed out, Jack, winners of 8 of 9. And they got one of the hottest lines in the NHL, centered by Malkin, who's just been a huge difference maker. Seems like every night he's been in action.
Johnny Boychuk back in the lineup after taking that butt end in the torso last game. And Evgeny Malkin, serious consideration for the Hart Trophy as the NHL's MVP.
Yeah, we discussed Malkin on the Instigators the other night. I said this is the time now where teams have to game plan for him, and I'm sure that's what the Bruins are doing.
Chara backs up and wrists it in to Marc-Andre Fleury, who catches it easily.
The strength down the middle for the Penguins in the absence of Crosby, in the absence of Staal, now you can really game plan for Malkin. Easier said than done, but try to get Chara and his partner, or however you want to go, and try to shut that line down. Neal on the right side, Kunitz on the left, Malkin in the middle, and that has to be one of your primary focuses.
Dustin Jeffrey to take the faceoff against Chris Kelly to Fleury's right, and Kelly wins it. Pouliot shoveling it back. Seidenberg's drive deflects off a Penguin and goes out of play.
Just a little slow developing. It's a good faceoff win in the offensive zone. The defense have switched sides to set up that play. Kelly gets a little help, wins the draw back, but it was a little slow going from Corvo to Seidenberg, and now it becomes an easier block.
Jeffrey wins it this time. Pollock to Paul Martin, up and out of the zone. Seidenberg D to D to Corvo. He whips it forward. It goes off the linesman's skate. McCulloch bounces it back through the neutral zone. If that name sounds familiar, that's the Ottawa forward Brummer. Kelly mucking along the boards in the Boston zone. It squirts free to Corvo. Pouliot shovels to Hamill. Hamill throws it in deep and gives chase against McCulloch. Tries to lift the stick. McCulloch puts the body in good position. Chips it off glass. Good anticipation. Pouliot goes in, steals the puck. McCulloch chops the backhand forward to Jeffrey. The short pass to Cook. Kelly puts the body on it, but McCulloch recovers the puck. Both teams change out. McCulloch patient in his own zone. And here's Malkin. Dan Bylsma saying before the game that there was a lot of concern about the matchups, and he's going to double shift McCulloch to try to get him away from Chara. Here's Malkin, the blast from Englund, and a save by Thomas, and the puck goes wide. Malkin backs up and drives another one. Lucic chips the puck along the line and out to center. Andrew Ferris has Peverly on his right, loses control of the puck. Niskanen up to Chris Kunitz. Back to Matt Niskanen. Niskanen and James Neal came to Pittsburgh in the Goligoski trade. Neal has so many nice attributes, Brick. He's got great hands, big body, decent speed, tremendous accuracy on his shot, willing to go to the greasy areas of the rink, just about everything you want in a young forward.
Yeah, he makes him such a valuable asset for this Penguins team because of all those attributes. And, you know, you mentioned decent speed. He has that long, powerful stride that is so deceptive. So I'd give him even good speed as far as my category.
The Acura key matchup. Take a look at this line. Whoa.
Yeah, get the job done since December 10th. That's 22 games for the Penguins, 33 points in the middle for Evgeny Malkin, 17 of those goals, and this line counting for better than 52% of Pittsburgh's output since mid-December.
Yeah, so, you know, word gets around pretty quickly. The sophistication of video scouting and tracking stats and the computerization of looking ahead to the next opponent So there's no mystery about it. They are facing the best defensive pair almost every shift and still producing. Here's Tyler Kennedy trying to get it on goal. Adam McQuaid beats Patrice Bergeron, tries to go all the way across ice, and a little touch from Marchand, but then the puck trickles along the line, and Marchand's a little ahead of the play offside.
Yeah, the puck got deflected on its way from Bergeron towards Sagan and Marchand. Marchand kept the play alive just outside the offensive zone, but when he touches this puck, he wants to keep moving. The question is he into the offensive zone prior to the puck? In the eyes of the linesman, he was.
Joe Vitale wins the faceoff against Gregory Campbell. Boy, did they have a dandy fight back on the 5th of December. Vitale took a couple of tremendous shots and just stayed on his skates. Vitale centers Thornton, takes it away in the defensive slot. Wing to wing to Paye, works it forward against McCulloch and makes the stick check. Craig Adams, who finished his 4 years at Harvard in the previous century. A 99er. Still playing in the NHL and still effective, especially on the penalty kill. Here's Thornton tossing the puck down the left wing boards. Martin locks up with Campbell. He throws the body in there. It's off Paye's skates. Up on the strings. Adams signaling for a whistle, and he gets one. Well, let's wind it back to December 5th. This was a dandy, wasn't it, Brady?
Well, the Bruins were just smoking at that time, winning all kinds of games, and feeling it. The strut, the cockiness. When the winds are there, and Vitale trying to do what he could do to try to get some momentum on the Penguins' side. They played a good game. They just couldn't beat Tim Thomas. And Vitale and Campbell locked up in a pretty good, not so much defensive kind of fight.
Yeah. H-O-C-K-E-Y-F-I-G-H-T. You didn't hear the letter D in there anywhere, did you? There was no D in that fight. And a Seidenberg stick handling away from Matt Cook, who, believe it or not, is on track for a 51-penalty-minute season after 129 last year. Dustin Jeffrey leading the rush in the middle. Drops off to Pascal Dubuque from his favorite shooting spot. And he drives it low into the middle of Thomas. Pollock forward for Cook. Tips it into the zone. Chara D to Corvo. Corvo the diagonal. Bergeron catches it on the backhand. Works against Englin. Centers looking for pulley out, but he can't make the redirection. Hamill chops it loose to the half boards. Niskanen skates it up to his own line. Hamill picks his pocket. Niskanen, good angle and the good body to get between Hamill and the puck. Boychuk steps forward and knocks Dupuy for a loop. Boychuk kicks it down to knock the puck into the attacking zone. Dustin Jeffrey scoops it over Sagan to the corner. Chara has the puck on the diagonal. Kunis tries to sweep it up the boards. Neal picks it off, steps to the middle. There's that deceptive speed. The shot off Boychuk's leg. Or Pictola tying the diagonal. Neal looking for it. Kunitz lets it go. Neal picks it up, scoots it to the middle. Only Chara there as he whacks it away from Malkin. Tyler Sagan up to the red line, bounces the backhand in deep.
And that's better fundamentals by Boston defensively. Even though Pittsburgh has possession of the offensive zone, everybody doing their job.
Andrew Ferentz told Malcolm Funayama before the game, just do what you do. Don't worry about anybody else's job. Do what you do. And if the Bruins can do that, all the combination work will come together.
Well, Neal tried to make that little backhand feed from along the goal line.
Sagan's drive goes off the stick, changes speeds, and flips over the top. Malkin goes up high against Peverly, or correction, Krejci.
And just to finish that thought, Jack, it was Zdeno Chara who was holding ground right in front of the net. That's doing his job. He makes the steal, leads the breakup.
McQuaid to Krejci, slips it to Peverly over the line. They crisscross. Peverly going in deep, throws it off the apron. His bowling pins, a couple of pins go to the end boards. Both defensemen, actually, it was Martin and McCulloch, but the Bruins can't take advantage. Sullivan behind Tyler Kennedy. Kyle O'Reilly just acquired on the 1st of February. Re-entry waivers as Phoenix tried to sneak him through, and he's reunited with his old Nashville linemate, Steve Sullivan. Sullivan on the end board. Comes out of the corner, the diagonal to McCulloch. Tees it up the slap pass, looking for O'Reilly in the seam. Beverly past Krejci, and McCulloch takes possession back. Pollock up the middle. Craig Adams tips it into the zone. Tyler Kennedy on the off wing, the backhander. Adams tips it, and it goes back to the goal. All the way around the boards. Engelin jumps off the Pittsburgh bench, keeps it in the attacking zone. Now Seidenberg turns the body, and Kennedy caves it in. Up comes Liz to McQuaid. Now Beverly throws the shoulder fake. Long indirect for Paye, working against Engelin. Gets the body inside. No icing goal. Paye showing his speed. Centers it. There's Vitali, the center, coming all the way back into his crease to make the defensive play. Richard Clark all the way to the corner. Seidenberg ties him up. Niskanen centers. It's off Vitali's stick. Clark scoots around, turns to the forehand. Seidenberg keeps him on the perimeter. Now he reverses past Vitali's reach. Niskanen down to the corner. Adams rotates high and sends the puck around the board. Seidenberg, the quick tap to Corvo, plays it cleanly out to Thornton. Thornton lugs it up the wing. Paye on the opposite side. Thornton can't get it cleanly through Niskanen. Adams turns the puck to Vitali. Engelin finds it in his skates. The wrist pass off a stick hits the dasher. Clark turns away from Kelly. Clark gains his own. Flicks it down past the Zamboni doors. Chara moves the puck around the boards to Pouliot. Chris Kelly reverses it. Pouliot with Hamill going middle. Pouliot uses the size, but Letang stabs the puck loose. Letang reverses the puck. Cook gathers it in. Kelly gets a piece of it. It comes back inside the zone. Pouliot had to tag up to stay onside. Dustin Jeffrey lobs the puck off the boards. Now it's McQuaid sending it across to Ferentz. Ferentz ahead. Pouliot almost toe picks, but here's Hamill. Gains the line. Works against Letang. Letang gives him a whack with the stick. The puck in on Fleury, and he covers for the faceoff. 11:57 to go in the first period. Shots two apiece, the Bruins and Pens.
Defense. One-on-one coverage. Take the shooting lanes away. The five-man house formation. Finish your checks. Good job right there, Boychuk. Now you got pressure on the puck. And who's hanging around in front? The man that's supposed to be there is Zdeno Chara. That leads to the steal and the breakout by Boston. Those are the fundamentals defensively Boston's looking for. Good example of it in the Bruins defensive zone.
Protect the house. Kennedy wins the faceoff back. Beverly pressures Letang. Lucic sweeps it right through the slot. Boychuk turns to the forehand, intentionally wide, great bounce. Beverly couldn't flick it up and over Letang. Boychuk with a brilliant carom shot off the kick plate. Beverly on the doorstep. Orpik wrestling with Beverly, keeps him from getting the stick down. Lucic unloads on Neal, and that's about 500 pounds of beef going bang. Boychuk forward off Krejci's backhand. Orpik one-hands it out of the zone. Kunitz drops it back, nobody home except the referee. Orpik goes to the body on Krejci. Letang chips off glass, it bounces past Boychuk. Here's a two-on-one. Neal closing, comes to the middle. The shot through the bodies and out the back as Boychuk got a piece of that. McCollum along the line to Martin. The snapshot, stick save Thomas, and it arcs over the glass into the protective net.
Pretty good opportunity for the Pittsburgh Penguins. They just tipped the puck out of the defensive zone. They were a little bit of trouble, and Boychuk couldn't handle it in center ice. And it essentially ends up being a two-on-two because Boychuk recovers on the far side, but a nice little curl and drag move by Neal gets the shot through traffic. Looks like Thomas gets a piece of it, Jack, with Kunitz on the net drive. So that's a nice job, an athletic stop by Tim Thomas to deal with that traffic and stay focused on the puck.
Tell you the truth, I was just trying to find the puck. Adam McQuaid to Andrew Ferentz around the boards. Brad Marchand can't get it past Paul Martin. Bergeron in the right place to keep Malkin from getting a chance. Now here's Marchand with speed. Turns off the half-board, Sagan fans, the puck trickles through and it's off the leg of Fleury. Marchand protects the puck along the boards. Turns it past McCulloch to Bergeron in the corner. Bergeron against Malkin, goes one way then the other, comes out the other side with the puck, backs it to Ferentz, the one-timer, he fouls it off. Marchand tries to shovel through to Bergeron. Ferentz's wrist shot, blocker save Fleury. Sagan down to a knee to get a piece of it, but Martin makes a nice clear out of the slot.
It looked like Sagan was trying to settle that puck and then zip it almost on a one-timer pass to Bergeron, open in the slot.
Dupuis sweeps the puck into the attacking zone. McQuaid D to D to Ferentz.
The two best Bruin opportunities in and around the net. They've got a fan on the puck. The puck bouncing on him a little bit. The first one on Beverly, the second one on Sagan.
Cook having trouble with Pouliot. Pouliot goes to the end boards. Shields the puck from Niskanen, reverses to Hamill. Hamill looking for help in front. Turns it off the end boards. Jeffrey with a good check against Hamill, shoving him off the path of the puck. Corvo over to Seidenberg. The snapshot never gets through as Niskanen and Campbell jam in front of the goal. Seidenberg lobs in the flick shot, and Fleury makes the glove stop. 9:39 to go in the first. Pretty good structure from the Bruins and the Pens so far. It's 0-0 at TD Garden.
Opportunities for the Boston Bruins. First one, a heads-up play by Johnny Boychuk. Took a pretty good angle to direct that slap shot to get it back to the front of the net. From that angle, you can see the puck just bouncing on Peverly. He knows he has to get rid of it quick before Letang gets into the shooting lane. Second opportunity. This time it's Sagan. Nice puck support. Short little pass for Marchand, but kind of heeled it a little bit. Didn't quite get the shot he was looking for.
Chris Letang sends it around the boards and out. Letang missed 21 games with a concussion. This is his seventh game back. Seidenberg turning away from Park's pressure. Here's Adams, but he can't keep the puck in his forehand thanks to Thornton's back pressure. High tries to self-pass around Orpik. Letang, outstanding skater, is there on the diagonal. Corvo breaks up the rush short of the red line, and it's offside as Pai is still inside the attacking zone.
Sign up now for the Neely Skate Challenge and help raise funds for children battling cancer and their families. These five skate-a-thon events begin Sunday, February 12th, and proceeds benefit the Boston Bruins Foundation and Cam Neely Foundation for Cancer Care. For information, visit NeelySkate.com.
Rick, midway through the first, sharpness improved for the Bruins?
Absolutely, absolutely. And I was trying to say that this isn't a conservative game the Bruins are playing, just high percentage play.
Yep. Andrew Ferentz in front of his own goal off Krejci's forehand. He's got Lucic on the left. Lucic fends off the O'Reilly check, now goes to work against Englund, bangs him twice down in the corner. Krejci shielding from Niskanen, the pass a little offline. Sullivan feeds Kennedy. Kennedy has O'Reilly rushing middle. All the way cross ice. Sullivan whacks the backhand to the corner. O'Reilly tries to return it. Lucic, the short pass to the available Peverly. Peverly, three on three over the line. Peverly to the backhand. To the short post. Fleury almost pulled off the post, but Peverly sends it into the pads. It'll be a faceoff.
Well, Milan Lucic sags back into that high slot area. He's in a good position to make the steal. Now you turn defense into offense. Close proximity, short passes, the most effective in the game. Peverly with great speed sees Lucic take that wide route, then cut to the net. That's going to open up a wide side, so he hangs onto the puck. He tries to sneak a puck right to the top of the crease. Maybe Lucic gets a swipe at him. Maybe it deflects off Mihalik and goes towards the goal. That's a pretty good rush, but it stops in the defensive zone.
Bergeron gets tossed off the faceoff dot. Sagan will go in to take it against Tyler Kennedy. Marchand. Sagan back to the goal. The backhander and a stop by Fleury. The puck rolls to the far side. Bergeron ties up Neal. Mihalik sends it back of his own goal to safety. Paul Martin there. Bergeron on the chase. Martin goes down. Now Sagan comes forward. Mihalik and Bergeron in a race. Malkin swooping all the way behind his own goal line. Now Kunitz from behind the red line kicks the puck all the way down into the Boston end. That will be icing. Dale Arnold can tell us what's going on between Jersey and Philadelphia. Dale. Dale, thank you. Philadelphia with 66 points in fourth place in the Eastern Division, and New Jersey with 59 points in seventh spot. Bergeron wins the draw. Marchand, good anticipation to get to the top of the circle. Banks at the chart. The snapshot saved by Fleury. Sagan goes down in a collision with Mihalik. Now Sagan and Mihalik to the near side. Sagan shows deep, comes back. Boychuk bangs it well wide. The puck ripples around at the far side. Marchand on the backhand tap. Malkin anticipating, takes it off the skates. Sagan forces him backward. Now Martin. Marchand puts the body on him. Kunitz, the backhand pass to Neal. Neal gains the Boston line. The wrist shot into Boychuk's skates. Kunitz's shot flips off a stick and goes out of play. The faceoff of the Boston end.
A strong shift by the Bergeron line. A lot of time in the offensive zone. Sagan had that near side sneaky little backhand that Fleury had to get a piece of. They didn't allow the Malkin line to get anything going. And then as Bergeron makes a change and Kelly gets onto the ice, good defensive players, right when Neal and Malkin wanted to get shots away.
Ferentz chips it off the back of Pouliot's legs. Now goes D to D behind the goal to McQuaid. The tap from Hamill off Jeffrey's stick. Cook jams with Hamill. Kelly can't get it clear. Dupuis attacking the puck. Ferentz, McQuaid, back to Ferentz from the red line. Off the corner boards, a scoop back to the middle on the hot hop. Cook goes hard to the boards in a collision with Ferentz. McQuaid back to retrieve the puck with Dupuis pressuring. Hard around the boards, it's off Hamill's stick and rolls on edge to Letang. Pouliot gives Letang a couple of spanks with the stick. Letang fights it off to across the red line to Cook. He gains the zone. Top of the slot to Dupuis. Fans on the shot with Hamill pressuring it. Ferentz to Pouliot. The outlet behind Kelly. Kelly finds it at the red line, just scoops it in deep so the Bruins can change out.
Yeah, Pouliot had an opportunity to carry that puck a couple of more strides. He wanted to move it quickly. Unfortunately, it was behind his intended target.
Niskanen for O'Reilly at the Boston line. Off his forehand, Corvo shoves it back for Niskanen, takes possession back. Derek Englund off the boards. Paille dropping back, picks it off. Off Englund's stick, and it slows down through the corner. Fleury has to wait for it inside the trapezoid. Gives it away. It's an adventure. Here's Corvo. Brings it to Seidenberg. Flips the pass ahead to Paille. Paille puts the brakes on against Englund. Indirect to Seidenberg. Holds it on the line. Corvo's wrist shot tipped twice. Hits Niskanen in the skates and comes to the corner. Niskanen battles Thornton for the puck there. Niskanen stick handles out of trouble up ahead to Cal O'Reilly. And here comes Sullivan trying to turn Corvo. Sullivan goes to the middle. The pass behind O'Reilly. They're a little out of sync. Paille has Thornton left hard around into the zone.
Well, Bruins had good back pressure though, Jack.
Hops over Sullivan's stick. Campbell fires it wide. Boychuk, the drive goes off the side of the goal. Takes a crazy high bounce and goes into the protective netting. The faceoff's going to come outside the zone. 5:28 to go, first period. 0-0, the Bruins in Pittsburgh.
Back pressure by Boston, one of the areas they needed to tighten up in order to allow their defense to have good gap control. Good example, Campbell on the back check just when Sullivan thought he had a 3-on-2, and then it was Campbell in that high slot on the drive by Boychuk. Nice little redirect, had Fleury beat short side, caught the outside of the post.
Boy, Tom Brady looks a lot younger in person than he does on Sundays, huh? Dano Chara flips the puck forward and it's offside. The faceoff back to the neutral zone. I keep coming back to what Pat Verbeek told us between periods. You don't want to go through something like this, but you kind of need to after you go through that incredible streak the Bruins did.
Yeah, and my question, and we didn't get to it when you made that point the other night after talking to Patty Verbeek, but my question was, all right, well, how long does it last?
Right. Malkin on the off wing. Well, that's a nifty defensive play by Tyler Seguin. He gives him a good two-hander right across the midsection and gets away with it. Here's Malkin turning out of the corner. Chara gives chase. Kunitz slips the pass to Neal, and Chara sends him for an e-ticket ride. A little behind the back, and then a chip by Marchand. Here he comes up ice with Seguin far side, and Bergeron filling late. Boychuk's bomb, save, rebound. Marchand somehow doesn't stay on the forehand, and Letang just gets it the heck out of there. Icing's better than picking one out of the back of your goal.
I think it was Letang that actually disrupted that rebound chance for Marchand. But the Bruins doing the job in all three zones with the Malkin line on the ice. Dangerous things can happen in your own zone. You got to have that back pressure. You got to have communication. Good angle by Seguin. He's involved, and then up ice, after a little self-chip pass by Marchand, got some separation from Letang. He's able to drop that puck back with a drive from the point. The rebound chance was there, but Letang able to reach back and make a good defensive play.
Chris Kunitz can't get it through Ferentz's skates. McQuaid banks the pass for Lucic, wing to wing to Peverly. Krejci going up the middle. Peverly closes, looking for Lucic, and Fleury trips him going through the slot. A bang-bang play, just inches from connecting. Sensational timing.
Well, I'll be disappointed if Lucic looked like he was jarring at the official. I don't know if he wanted some kind of penalty the way you saw it, Jack. I just want to make sure the referee was saying, don't hit the goalie. He's driving to the net, and he stayed out of the blue paint.
Yeah. Wow, if goalies get protected on that, wow.
Yeah.
And then it's open season on forwards.
Okay, Linda.
Oh, boy. McCulloch wrists it off the corner boards. Thomas knocks it down. Ferentz into Pouliot's skates. Pouliot wrists it with some air under it. Tyler Kennedy on the off wing working against Chris Kelly. Correction, it's Vitali now brings it back. Niskanen off the stick of Hamill, and it lobs up and out of play with 3.5 to go in a pretty entertaining first period.
You know, in the absence of Nathan Horton, how is the Krejci line going to be affected with Pevely playing the right side? All you can do as a player, if you're Milan Lucic, just play your game. And Lucic has been good here in the first period. He's had his legs moving. Gets in on the forecheck. Good body contact on Englund. Defensively responsible, well-positioned. Stopped the breakout. And he's been all around the net.
Dustin Jeffrey. Seidenberg stabs it loose. Campbell working against Dupuis. Puck comes loose. Thomas pokes it out of the crease as Jeffrey got it goalward. Now Corbo, one hand flick to Thornton, gets enough on it to get the puck across to Paille, center circle. It dribbles past Englund into the corner. Paille in to pressure, Campbell takes the boards, and Englund makes a nice poised pass to Jeffrey, who came way below the dot to make himself available. Now Cook into Seidenberg's corner, ties up Seidenberg, gives him the hit. Corbo chops it around the boards, and it gets past Niskanen all the way to center.
Yeah, that's the case with a puck bouncing helps Boston. Niskanen made a nice read, was there, and plenty of time to keep that puck in on the pinch, but jumped right by him.
Dupuis all the way to the attacking line to Cook. Cook getting booed here for many past misdeeds. One of those. Fleury stops it back at his own goal. Letang winds it out. Now Brooks Orpik cracks it around the corner. Bounces over Thomas's stick. Chara has a little bit of trouble from Kennedy. Bergeron to Sagan along his own line. Boychuk banks the pass to Marchand to Bergeron. Pulls up in a little bit of space. Finds Sagan top of the circle back to Chara. Chara tries to get through Sullivan on the backhand all the way past the goal line. Now Marchand brings it back to Bergeron. The one-timer whistles wide. Might have been tipped in front. Boychuk taps it down to Sagan to Bergeron. The shot and a save by Fleury on the stick side. Bergeron whips it through Letang's stick. Chara down to the half boards, slides down, takes the puck all the way to the corner. Letang turns out the right side of his defensive zone. Tyler Kennedy waits for Sullivan. The soft bank pass. Marchand bangs it back to center. Malkin brings it cross ice to Niskanen.
That save by Fleury on Bergeron almost looked like it hit the butt end of his stick before he moved.
Yep, the shot to the stick, huh? Well, sometimes better lucky than good. Malkin cross ice to Englund. Englund finds the puck. Here's Neal with a little bit of space. Kunitz in the middle of the shot. Ferentz blocks it. Neal fires it off the end boards. Niskanen scoops the backhander forward to Kunitz. Kunitz takes the pop from Ferentz. One hands it toward Neal, but Lucic is there to break it up. Beverly, three on three up ice. Krejci through the seam, goes to the boards against Englund. Englund drives the shoulder into Krejci's chest in the final minute of the first period. Kunitz out of his own crease. McQuaid breaks up the pass at the red line. But here comes Malkin. Malkin, the tight radius turn. Krejci's down in the Pittsburgh again. And we get a slash called here.
Well, the penalty's going to be on Rich Pevely. The slash on Malkin. When Malkin was trying to curl up when he was about 10 feet inside the offensive zone. But Krejci down because he got hit hard along the wall when he was trying to get to a loose puck because he had Lucic at the top of the crease. A potential three-on-two coming through the neutral zone. And Pevely slides the puck to David Krejci. But then when the puck turns over, that's your stick infraction by Pevely on the back check, which will give the Penguins the power play. But it was this hit right here by Englund on Krejci. You can see Krejci trying to get his footing, get his balance, and get back in the play. He'll make his way to the Bruins locker room.
Not putting too much weight on the left leg. So Pittsburgh goes to the power play. 0-2 with a man advantage at Toronto on Wednesday. 0-3 in the last two games and just two power play goals in the last seven for the Penguins. Malkin, the wrist shot. Marchand blocks it and he makes it clear. Keep your eyes on number 18 in white when Pittsburgh has the power play this afternoon. James Neal has a league-leading 13 power play goals. Sullivan has to make the extra move of the Boston line, and with 22 seconds to go in the period, it's offside.
Yeah, Bruins stack it up at the defensive blue line, four across, and that really slows down the power play attack. In many cases, you get offsides when you have four across, and the puck carrier really has no options.
Rich Mitch Peverly, by the way, in the regular rotation of penalty-killing forwards. He ranks fourth among Bruins forwards in shorthanded time on ice per game with a minute and 48. The team leader, no surprise, the man taking the faceoff, Patrice Bergeron, at 205 per game among forwards. Mark into the half boards, cross ice. There's Neal, the drive, St. Thomas rebound, comes through to Malkin, he scores! Evgeny Malkin, as he has so often in the last 8 weeks, puts Pittsburgh on top. James Neal, the power play assist.
Well, not a whole lot of time on the clock when the faceoff is in the neutral zone. There's a heads-up play by Sullivan on the fake dump-in, and then he just zips it right across. That's only about a 10-foot pass. Allows Letang easy access into the Boston zone. Now they can make a play. Malkin goes from one side of the ice to the other for the drive by Neal, and this is a good break. Kunitz chops at it, squirts through the legs, and then a sideburn, and there's Malkin. When you're hot, the puck will find you, and Malkin makes no mistake with just 8 seconds to go in the period. A period where the Bruins played a strong game. Good structure, high percentage plays. They had some offensive opportunities where they didn't finish, the puck bouncing and spinning, and the offense will come. The focus was on their defensive structure, their good positioning, and the back pressure, and control the defensive part of the game. And Pittsburgh cashes in on a power play, and those are the types of goals that you can't let you get you down because it was a good period.
Well, let's start the MVP discussion because Malkin not only drew the penalty, but ended up scoring the power play goal. By the way, from the truck, we get a message that it sounds as if it might just be a broken skate with David Krejci, so we'll cross our fingers on that one. Barry and Gord are on the fifth floor with Dale Arnold. Time for the New England Nissan Dealers First Intermission Report live from the AT&T Sports Deck. Dale, take it away. Very much, a whole lot of peacocks showing up there in the month of February, aren't they? Now goes report from the Xfinity High Def Zone, brought to you by the Xfinity Triple Play, Xfinity TV, Internet, and Voice. With Nowco alongside the ice, Andy Brickley alongside up here on the ninth floor, I'm Jack Edwards. It's the Dunkin' Donuts Turbo Shot. Need an extra boost? Try adding a Turbo Shot of espresso to any Dunkin' Donuts beverage of your choice. America runs on Dunkin'. Sidney Crosby running at relatively high speed this morning, skating on his own as he comes back from a soft tissue injury in his neck. Crosby now has missed 84 games over the last two seasons, so it's basically a missing year for the greatest player on the planet when he is healthy.
It's just so encouraging to see him on the ice, and we all got excited across the hockey community when he first came back this year and lit up the Islanders in game one for 4 points, I believe. And then have that setback after some contact, a couple of hits, unintentional hits, incidental contact, in fact, with David Krejci. But good to see him back on the ice, and I want to see him back in the National Hockey League this year, Jack.
I think all hockey fans do. David Krejci has returned to the Boston bench, so as suspected, it seems as if it's an equipment situation. Here's Kunitz, the backhand, all the way to the far corner. Orpik chops it around. Chara with Neal closing in. Neal finishes his check, but Sagan making himself available for the short pass. Gains the line. The wrist shot off Letang's skate. Letang to Malkin. Off Kunitz's blades. Bangs around. Marchand goes through, wins the puck. Back to Boychuk. Boychuk gets Kunitz down. Fires bad angle. Fleury can't control it near the post. Marchand in the corner to Bergeron. The drive goes over the top. Chara with a big reach knocks it down at center.
Yeah, Jack, I liked a lot of what Boston did defensively in their own zone with the structure, their decision-making. Now the offense has to follow.
Bergeron with the open side to Sagan. The drive, and it goes over the top. Marchand wiggling to the top of the circle. Seidenberg holds, chips it down the boards, around the corner. Sagan trying to get away from Letang, who is attempting to lock down the stick, but Sagan strong on the puck. Here's Bergeron whipping across ice, looking for Corbeau, a little too far forward. Matt Cook takes the puck up. Fires at the length of the rink, a bounce up on the apron of the goal, and Seidenberg gets the tap, but it is not icing. Seidenberg hammers it away from Pascal Dupuis. Mikhalyk down to the corner. Lucic puts the shoulder into him. Mikhalyk at the faceoff dot. Brings it back past Cook all the way to the point, and Martins passes offline to center. Pollock wrists it around the Dashers. Thomas gets the body against the board. Corvo, long indirect for Lucic at the red line, angles the skate to Peverly, flips it ahead for Krejci, but O'Reilly tracking back against Krejci. Krejci shoves the backhand to Corvo along the line to Seidenberg, the drive tipped in front, Peverly, and it rockets off the glass. Through Fleury's glove, Lucic takes the puck down in the corner. The Bruins finding an attacking rhythm here early in the second. Rich Peverly scooting all the way up to the blue line, but the pass goes off Cook's legs. Now O'Reilly flips it off Corvo's stick to the corner.
Now the Bergeron line had a couple of real good opportunities. They missed the net. Then this line came out, the Krejci line. Good breakout by Lucic to find Peverly. Nearly sent Krejci alone.
Peverly to Lucic up the left wing. Englund puts the shoulder in and Lucic knocks him backward.
That's just good hard hockey right there. Englund didn't go for that low hip jack. Shoulder to shoulder, two big bodies. And Lucic does the right thing. Keep the puck moving into the offensive end.
Bouncing puck gets over Matt Niskanen. Fleury to Niskanen. Chops it off the corner boards. Here's Englund. Kelly finishes his check. Puck gets all the way to the Boston line. Adam McQuaid draws Tyler Kennedy. Now Andrew Ferentz with a quick step up the middle. The long angle pass to Kelly. Kelly holds. Ferentz goes forward. Kelly's drive goes off a body and angles off the glass. Matt Kennedy picks it up, trying to get past Pouliot, who pokes it loose and whacks it away from Vitali. Puck drifts in front of the Boston bench. Hamill off of Kennedy's skates. Adams sends the puck forward on a self-pass. Ferentz stretches the strides, and that's icing against the Pens.
Well, the Bruins looking to take the next step here in their recovery to being a dominant team. The first period was all about defense and getting the job done. This period, let's try to find the rhythm of our offense. Bergeron had a real good chance, ripped it wide, blocker side high. Sagan on the one-timer, he too elevating the puck a little bit too high. That puck did not lay flat for Sagan, otherwise that puck's going to be inside that 6x4.
Kennedy wins the faceoff. Paille with the angle and the effort to get to the puck in the end boards. Now Thornton on the near side. Englund gives him a shove. Paille stays with it. Here's Thornton in traffic. Stick handles the shot off the back of Campbell, I believe. Kennedy finds a loose puck. 3-on-2. Vitali, the Northeastern product, drops off to Adams. Off Vitali's stick to the corner. Thornton circles back, flips it past James Neal. Orpik knocks it down.
It was a 3-on-2 for the Penguins, but Tyler Kennedy decided to go for line change.
Neal, stick handles over the line. Chara keeps him from getting a clean shot, and the puck goes up and over.
Tonight at 10, it's Nesson Daily with Randy Scott, presented by Sun Life Financial. Get more on the Penguins and Bruins, and all you need to know before tomorrow's big game in Indianapolis. All that and more tonight at 10.
Malkin, Kunitz, and Neal, the stud line for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Bergeron wins the faceoff in the defensive zone. Kunitz attacking Boychuk. Boychuk draws the four checkers, gets it to Char, to Bergeron, to Sagan, in open ice against Letang, goes inside to Marchand, and a save by Fleury. Marchand stays with it, turns to the dot, fires, and it goes to the corner boards. Chara flicks it one-handed, Letang gloves it down, chips it past Chara and back to center. What a marvelous rush by the Bruins, and a nice save by Fleury.
Now Pittsburgh tried to go with an aggressive two-man forecheck, and the Bruins handled it nicely. Boychuk to Chara. They use the middle of the ice on the breakout. Now you have speed through the neutral zone, and Sagan, those great stick skills, able to step inside Letang and find Marchand on the net drive. That's how you draw it up. You just want to have the finishing touch. There's the two-man forecheck by the Malkin line. Wide open in the middle of the defensive zone. Work that puck wide. Good net drive on the far side to get away from Malkin by Marchand. But Fleury able to keep the Bruins off the board.
Bergeron wins it to Marchand. The shot saved by Fleury. Letang whacks the backhand forward to Kunitz. He sweeps it cross ice. Neal reaches back between the skates to field the puck. How's that for good hand? Corvo takes the hit from Neal in the corner. Bergeron sees Malkin coming, flips it up to the hash marks. Neal attacks Marchand with the puck. Now Corvo fights through Kunitz, flips it past Marchand. McCulloch fakes the shot, now takes it, saved by Thomas. Rebound by Malkin, and he hits the post from no angle, and the forehand was by the goal line. Bergeron into Marchand skates, leaves the puck behind. Neal wants transition off of that, throws it into space ahead of Malkin.
You see how the puck finds you when you're hot? Malkin was way off to the side of the net on that deflected shot off the save by Thomas, and it found him.
Cook flips it into the slot. Here's Malkin. Corvo chops it out of there. Cook's shot blocker saved Thomas off the end glass. Corvo pulls up short. Pittsburgh changing. Corvo off the stick of Dupree, and it lobs into the seventh row.
Well, the Bruins had a little trouble along the wall, deep in their own zone, and puck gets chipped past Marchand. Good little pump fake by McCulloch in order to make sure he had a lane around Marchand. The save, and then the rebound goes directly to Malkin. He's away from the net by the goal line. You got to think he's anticipating, maybe I can't get to the front of the net, so if this shot is wide, I want to get to the wall and keep it in the offensive zone. Well, it's a save, and it goes right to him, and he rings one off the pipe.
Magnetic. Zach Hamill, the curl and drive. The shot goes off of Martin's leg and wide. McCulloch in the corner. Hamill throws the shoulder into him. Chara pinching down past the hash marks. Hacks it over into the far corner to Pouliot. Pouliot on the arc. Puck picks his pocket. Pouliot turns the body. Stays over the puck. Gets twisted around. And we're going to get a hooking call here.
Yeah, he almost looks like he's pointing right at Pouliot, isn't he?
That's the call.
Now on the back check, after Pouliot tries a little curl and drag move away from Cook, that doesn't work, and just enough stick action apparently in on Cook to be deemed a penalty. Tough call to go against Boston. Only difference in the game is that power play goal by Malkin at the tail end of the first period. They're going to have another power play opportunity right here.
The Pens weren't on the power play long, but they did get three shots. Very potent. Peverly wins the draw to begin the power play for Pittsburgh, and Letang seals it in at the right point. Letang to Neal, the one-timer, dribbles through Chara, and Thomas pounces on it.
Well, Letang, because he's such a gifted skater with real good offensive instincts, they want him to play high on the umbrella and really work side to side. He has Sullivan a right-handed shot on one side, and Neal with his big shot on the opposite side. No surprise they're going to shoot the puck from out there.
Sullivan taps low. Neal shields the puck. Kunitz flips it in front. Thomas sticks it out. And Peverly helps get the puck out of the zone. Only about half a minute gone on the Pittsburgh power play. Steve Sullivan forward to James Neal behind Kelly. Neal's shot. And Thomas comes out of his goal to get a piece of it. Letang cross ice, Sullivan shovels it low to Neal. Neal back to Sullivan, long passes tape to tape. Neal turns at the dot, the shot with Kunitz screening in front of Thomas. He makes the blocker stop. Letang down to a knee at the point, keeps it in. Malkin tries to come off the half boards and Kelly flicks it the length of the ring.
Not a good decision to try to wrap the puck around initially by Chara, but Chara recovered with a good read to force Malkin to create the turnover.
Now Malkin with the huge strides into the Boston zone with Cook on his right, flips the puck into the corner. Ferentz takes care of Cook. Pae, second effort, gets it past Malkin. Campbell just past his own blue line, softly off the boards. Pae stretching against Letang, wheels it through the crease. Campbell turns and drives it. It was going wide, but Fleury gets the leg down. Chris Letang gains the Boston line, flips it to space in front of Matt Cook. Cook bangs the backhand around. Kennedy on the far side. He's got Niskanen at the left point. Kennedy closes to the dot. The shot off of Ferentz, and it goes to the end boards. Boychuk stabs at the puck. Kennedy brings it back to Niskanen. Niskanen's blast! That whistles all the way through as Pae went down right in front of the shot. Letang off of Campbell. Ferentz stacks up Letang. Neal comes up with the puck. Letang with a lot of space goes back to the goal. Flips it over. The centering pass. Thomas keeps the leg down. Here's Kennedy. Flips it into the slot. Campbell finds it first. Sends it the length of the rink as Pouliot exits the box.
You couldn't tell from our angle if that backhand chip by Kennedy was inside the post and Thomas had to get with the block or the right arm.
Five shots on the power play just expired. A total of eight on the man advantage. That's more than half of Pittsburgh's shots this afternoon. The Pens have 14 in the game. Tyler Seguin over the line of the vulnerable minute. Wheels it back to the slot. McQuaid bunts it loose, but it's a 3-on-2 in transition. Here's Dupuis, top of the circle, closes, fakes, gets Thomas way out, sends it back to Adams, the drive into the pile, it's loose. Bergeron makes the play in the defensive slot. Marchand brings it up ice against McCulloch. Goes slow then fast, turns at the hash marks, looks for Bergeron, it's off a stick. Corvo dribbles it all the way toward goal, and a piece of stick went into the goal. Now here's Dupuis going to the corner. Dupuis centers it off of a leg and it comes all the way to the near side board. It's end to end. Oh, Dupuis from behind on Seguin. He goes down. And an immediate whistle. They'll take a look at Seguin. to count Chicklets and maybe see if he's got a split lip. Bruins are going to have the man advantage for the first time when the game resumes. Driven by your New England Chevy dealers.
The Bruins with some real good penalty killing, keeping this game at 1-0, and then speed through the neutral zone. Sagan had good legs here today. Gets a little body position on Dupuis on the back check. Dupuis trying to reach around and lift Sagan's stick, but he misses and catches Sagan in the face. That's good for 4 minutes, Jack.
Bruins with 4 power play goals in their last 4 games. The Pens have killed 14 of the last 15 shorthanded situations they have faced. A redrop here. No time coming off the clock. Krejci gets tossed out. So Peverley will come in from the right point to take it against Joe Vitale. Vitale wins the draw to Orpik. It bounces around. McCollum tries to muscle it up the boards. Peverley in traffic, gets double teamed. Pouliot fights it loose. Chara uses the foot to ensure that the puck stays in the zone. A little collision between Orpik and Fleury back of the Pittsburgh goal. Orpik bangs it off the glass, gets it to center ice. Peverley takes a big hit from Adams to keep the puck forward of the red line. Pouliot pivots over the attacking blue line. Now here's Chara along the line to Peverley. Chara middle of the line. He has Krejci out high. The one-timer goes off of McCulloch. Lucic rotates it. Pouliot, who will be the big body in front, brings it back to Peverley along the line to Chara. Peverley moves to the middle of the line to draw Vitale. Here's Krejci dragging it. Peverley fakes the shot. Chara below the dot. The wrist shot saved by Fleury. He'll take the faceoff with 3:11 to go in the double minor.
Puck possession in the offensive zone, but everything to the perimeter. The one shot that they tried to work and the high umbrella was blocked in front by McCulloch. Now David Krejci's trying to work that high side, create the 2-on-1. He's going to drift back to the middle, go back to Peverley, but Chara's down by the dot. If you're going to give up shots and you're killing penalties, those are the shots to give up. You expect Fleury to make that save.
Dupuis ranks third among the penalty-killing forwards for Dan Bylsma in shorthanded time on ice per game. And in the course of a 4-minute penalty, that should be a factor. Dupuis, obviously a dangerous player in a lot of different ways, but penalty-killing is one of his great strengths.
Yeah, and even though it's just a 1-0 game and you're looking for the tying goal in these 4 minutes, take that 2-minute attitude.
Here's Marchand looking for Bergeron just out of the reach. Marchand the tap pass to Seidenberg. Bergeron in the corner. Sagan emerging from the goal line. Corvo sneaking in the weak side. Sagan comes off the half-boards, cross ice. Corvo the shot. Great move by Fleury. Corvo flips it off the strings. Fleury going right to left strongly and denying Joe Corvo on the cross ice Sagan pass.
Yeah, Corvo didn't get a lot on this shot. He got enough, but he didn't get a lot on it. It was a nice look by Sagan. Move your feet, work the overload. Bergeron, that's a nice 2-on-1. There's your cycle. And if you keep moving, now you start to attack. What opens? That backdoor seam. And it was a little bit down on the heel, I believe, of Corvo's stick, so we didn't get a ton on it, but Fleury was there.
Krejci and Jeffrey, and Krejci wins the puck to the corner, banks it back to Peverley, and it explodes on him back to center. 2:15 to go on the double minor. Lucic angles the puck down to the end board. Orpik draws it into his own skates. Pouliot attacks the puck, hammers away on the kick blade. A lot of chaos back there. Lucic indirect to Peverley, and again the puck explodes on him, pops up shoulder high back to center. One shot on the first power play, two shots corrected now. Here's Peverley with a shift on Letang. Brings it out near side, Krejci to Chara. The one-timer, save, rebound, Peverley. Orpik tying him up. And Adams spanks the puck the length of the rink.
Yeah, similar rebound that found Malkin. That one found Peverley, but on the backhand side, didn't have a chance to pull it for him.
Thomas didn't get much on it to Chara, but he gets it around to Marchand. Now Corvo with Vitale closing. Corvo accelerates through the middle of the neutral zone, flicks the puck into Martin's corner, goes and gets it himself, and McCulloch is there to get a piece of the puck. The angle pass, Seidenberg with terrific hustle across ice. Sagan fans with a one-timer as Cook got the stick in the way. Now here's Bergeron. Couple of turns, back to Seidenberg. He drills it off Richard Park. Seidenberg fires it in front. Marchand on the doorstep tip, knocked it to the corner. Corvo wheels it around the board. Sagan on the backhand. Protects the puck against Martin. Sagan, diagonal to Corvo, gloves it down Seidenberg with Cook right in his face. Sagan on the half boards, finds Corvo, cross ice, Corvo, the slap pass for Bergeron, but Colic angling it to the end boards. Marchand to Sagan. Sagan stick handles, turns away from Martin. Martin gets a piece of it. Bergeron, indirect to Seidenberg. Draws it toward the middle. Now Corvo, Cox and fires, and a save by Fleury as Marchand got cleaned out in front on Martin's hit. Corvo keeps the puck in the attacking zone. 25 seconds to go in the power play. The saucer pass to Seidenberg. Slap pass just out of Bergeron's reach as Cook makes the play and then clears it 200 feet.
That's a big play by Cook because the penalty killers were absolutely spent. If the Bruins could have kept that puck even in the offensive zone a little longer and not allow a whistle, their chances of scoring increased dramatically.
5 seconds to go on the man advantage. Peverly going to the corner. Here's Boychuk saving it at the line. Kick saved by Fleury, and it's ruled that the puck got past the paint and it's offside. The power play comes to an end. 7:03 to go, second period. The Pens with a huge kill, keeping their 1-0 lead. Presented by Amica Insurance. It's not just how you're covered, it's how you're treated.
Well, the Bruins do a nice job of working the overload on one side to get that cycle game going in this direction here between Bergeron and Sagan, and then that top man, Corvo, he's going to look back door. It's well executed, puck movement, body movement, now the seams open, and the minute you attack from that half wall, you're going to have that play back door if the Penguins don't have good stick position or awareness. Unfortunately for Boston, Corvo couldn't elevate that puck or got a little bit more on it.
Malkin wins the draw against Chris Kelly. Derek Englund taps it over. Matt Niskanen long diagonal. Pouliot gets the stick on the puck. Johnny Boychuk away from James Neal. Now Zdeno Chara. Zach Hamill wiggles around. Chris Kunitz gains the line. Flips it off to Kelly. Kelly's shot looking for Chara in front. And Englund ties up the Boston big man. The bank pass gets away from Malkin. Boychuk swings it over to Kelly.
Yeah, pretty soft coverage by Pittsburgh. They allowed Boston to walk right in their own zone.
And here comes Kelly again. Stick handling all the way to the slot. Englund up ahead to Neal. Doesn't get much on the backhand tap. Chara at the red line to Pouliot. Pouliot turns over the line. Malkin with back pressure. Pouliot shields the puck. Whacks the backhand around. Kelly with a good shoulder on Englund. Here's Chara along the line to Boychuk. The snapshot saved by Fleury as Hamill's trying to create traffic.
AT&T is giving you the chance to go PJ shopping with Milan Lucic. Text PJ to 27722 to donate $5, then opt in for your chance. Proceeds go toward the purchase of PJs that will be donated to Cradles to Crayons. Message and data rates may apply. For terms, rules, and alternate form of entry, visit bostonbruins.com.
Terrific hockey game we got going here this afternoon at TD Garden. Bruins out shooting the Penguins 19-14. The only goal coming very late in the first period on a power play by Pittsburgh. Paille turns away from Brooks Orpik. Now wheels on him again. Banks the pass to Ferentz. Ferentz hard along the line to McQuaid. McQuaid's wrist shot tipped in front as O'Reilly and Paille are going for the puck, and O'Reilly got more stick than Paille did in the faceoff in the Pittsburgh zone.
Well, Bruins doing a nice job using that point-to-point pass in the offensive zone. Sometimes you want to spread the offense. We almost go board-to-board, make sure that puck doesn't get picked off. And other times you want to shorten it up, cut the ice in half.
O'Reilly and Thornton. Thornton finally wins the faceoff, and Letang snaps the backhand cross ice. Tyler Kennedy gains the line with speed. Kennedy shot, save Thomas, big rebound, but Thornton is there. Thornton loops it out end over end into the center circle. Orpik with a tremendous hit on Paille, sending him flying like a teddy bear across a kid's bedroom. Paille chips the puck down the board. Letang flips the puck back to center. I'm sure Paille didn't feel like one though, did he?
Well, Orpik was just getting a low center of gravity. He wanted to steady himself because he was actually playing the puck.
Yeah, exactly. About as clean a hit as you can get. It was his puck, and Paille just stepped in front of the train. Corvo, a little shoulder fake on Cook. Cook gets the body on him. Crowd wants a call, but there's nothing wrong with that. Thornton up the boards. Orpik knocks it down at his own line. Orpik skies one into about the 16th row. Not known for his hands as much as his body, Brooks Orpik. Still 1-0 Pens. Who was the Bruins' first pick in the 2004 NHL draft? the year the Penguins took Evgeny Malkin with the number 2 overall pick? Visit Nesson.com/the4s for the answer. Enter to win a $50 gift certificate that can be used at the 4s Restaurant and Sports Bar in Boston, Quincy, or Norwell. Dustin Jeffrey wins the faceoff. Martin down into the corner. Seidenberg loads up for a big hit and flattens Cook, much to the delight of many of the onlookers at TD Garden. Mikhalyk up the boards. Dupuis knocks it down. Jeffrey rushing the net. Dupuis driving to Seidenberg's legs. Cook wheels. The puck flips harmlessly through the slot. Peverly up the boards and it rolls past the red line. Mikhalyk banks the pass into the gap. Corvo can't clear the zone. Cook and Peverly wrestle for the puck. Peverly wins the puck battle. Krejci with a sweet pivot to get the puck to Corvo. The defenseman pulls up short, changes out, and bounces the puck to the corner. Lucic looking in front. The puck comes all the way back to Kunitz. Here's Chara with the steal. Chara takes the puck to the corner. Chara holds it on the perimeter. Backhands it toward the crease. It bounces back to the end board. Milan Mikhalyk hoists it out to center. It bounces past Boychuk and bites in, so it won't go for icing. Kunitz finishes his check on Boychuk. Chara ahead to the Pittsburgh line. Engelin back to the red line. Bergeron to Marchand. He skids it in wide of Fleury's goal. Engelin hard off the end boards. Kunitz chips it ahead. Here's Malkin 2-on-1 with Neal against Chara. Malkin closes. Chara down. And you just can't get it under that. Maybe over, but certainly not under. Chara unloads on Kunitz. Boychuk to Chara. The crowd buzzing as Chara took away about half the ice. Elevate it? Yeah, maybe. But when you got a guy who's 6'9" plus the longest stick in the league going down and keeping it flat, not much chance of getting it under. Adams a little tap, and there's Sagan all the way back at the dot in the defensive zone. He dances through the neutral zone. Sagan stick handling, putting Englund in trouble. Right in front for Kelly, and it bounces off the end glass. Tyler Sagan with a tremendous rush. Marchand takes the Adams hit, works on Letang in the corner. Kelly mucks for the puck. He whacks it back around the corner boards. Vitali backs in, gets good position, and then banks the pass for Adams. Adams lugs it out of his own zone on the right side, finds Vitali, kicks to the stick, works against Ferris, drops to Parker, shot saved by Thomas on the right pad, still loose in the slot. Pouliot gets it to Hamill, who whips it out. Adams cross ice for Orpik. Orpik pass through the seam. Vitali angles it for Park. Park stick handles to the corner. Letang charging toward goal. Park brings it to the near post, and the Bruins pile it up the whistle, even though the puck plainly is lying in the space behind Thomas's net.
A couple opportunities for the Penguins just before this little scrum or wrist shot, or a little half slap on the drop pass from Vitali off the stick of Park, I believe. And prior to that was this two-on-one, potential two-on-one with Malkin carrying the puck. Questionable pinch by Johnny Boychuk left Chara back there to have to play center field. The Bruin captain laid out with nice timing, stick fully extended, not allowing Malkin a chance to step inside him.
Just trying to do the math in my head, you know. Chara's arm extended plus the stick, that was probably what, 12, 13 feet of ice that got taken away all at once.
Yeah. A little out of my range if I was putting, I know that.
You called me a putz again? Cal O'Reilly. O'Reilly to take the faceoff against David Krejci. Krejci wins it back to Corvo. 2.5 to go in the second period. The Bruins working toward 5 consecutive periods without a goal scored. Here's Rich Peverly. Krejci below the dot. Corvo is slap pass cross ice. Seidenberg takes it past Kennedy. Low to Lucic. Lucic shields the puck from Kennedy. Comes up to the half boards. Corvo's one-timer saved by Fleury. Kicks it to the corner board. Fleury has an outstanding record at TD Garden. Corvo shot, Lucic with the high slot tip. Peverly tries to shovel it through. Lucic mucks for the puck. Mikhalyk bangs it off the referee, I believe, and it comes back the other way. Martin out of the corner. And Corvo knocks it down to the Boston line. The flick into the center circle. Peverly can't get it past Mikhalyk. Here comes Kennedy. Kennedy to Sullivan with space on Corvo's side. The shot off Thomas. Weird bounce to the near side as Thomas had to make a shrug the shoulder save. Sullivan off the end boards for O'Reilly. Kennedy holds at the hash mark, centering it, looking for O'Reilly's doorstep tip. The Bruins get too many sticks in the way. Krejci to Peverly, the Bruins need a change. Peverly takes it wide as the Bruins get fresh legs on the ice. Peverly holds Charles, one-timer just wide on the glove side. Boychuk to the half-boards. Sweeps it all the way around. Now Marchand at the hash marks. Orpik gives him a bang. Sagan gets his shoulders over the puck to keep it in the attacking zone for the moment. Final minute of the second period. The Bruins gave one up in the final minute of the first. That's the only goal of the game. Chara mugs Kunitz in the corner. Al Bergeron stick handles and flips it over Neal's stick all the way to the point. Letang sends it back in deep. 45 seconds to go in the period as Sagan gives the puck back to Boychuk. Chara got wiped out in a collision in the traffic. Letang back in his own end, snaps it off the boards. Here's Malkin finding the puck with Cook going past him. Malkin off a body, it bounces all the way to Letang at the point. Letang fakes the slap pass, now fakes wristing it, and finally throws it down through the corner. Marchand hits the brakes, Neal goes by. Boychuk and Cook along the kick plate. Boychuk has his skates taken out from under him on Neal's hit. Bergeron clears through the neutral zone. There's going to be icing with about 4 seconds to go in the period as Letang gets back for it.
Well, the Bruins still with a goose egg up on the scoreboard. You mentioned, Jack, difficult time finding the back of the net right now. The 3-0 loss to Carolina. How about this opportunity? Sagan backs everybody off with the great speed, makes a perfect pass right to the top of the crease. Kelly going to the net as he should, makes that redirect, but that too up over the crossbar.
Bergeron wins the faceoff from Malkin, and that will kill off the final seconds of the second period. After 40 minutes, it's Pittsburgh 1 and Boston 0.
Well, you expected some kind of game like this where it was either going to be a big-time play or special teams. Something was going to be the difference between these two teams. 1-0, third period. Bruins are still in good shape. I like the way they're playing. Now they got to start to find that finishing touch.
Yeah, both of these teams great in the third period. Should be a terrific finish. Barry Peterson, Gord Kluzak on the desk with Dale Arnold. The New England Ford Dealer second intermission report coming your way live from the AT&T Spin is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by your New England Chevy dealers, by AT&T. Get it faster with 4G. Rethink possible. By Dunkin' Donuts. By Toyota's official website, buyatoyota.com. And by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. 1-0 Penguins heading into the third period on a great afternoon game at TD Garden. The Kettle One honorable moment. Dennis Seidenberg, the day after the birth of his son, with a little bit of German engineering, yeah. The puck maybe bending a little bit and going in. The center ice winner as the Bruins come from behind to beat the Sens 4-3. Moments ago, Naoko Funayama spoke with Bruins assistant coach Doug Jarvis. Naoko, the Bruins are on the wrong side of the score, but are they on the right side of progress?
The right side of progress for sure. Jarvis can certainly see from up top. The defensive zone coverage is much improved. The breakouts are much better. Now he says, let's generate some offense. Now they're getting those first shots through, but they need to get those second chance opportunities. And, you know, he says really it's about working in the tough areas. It's been a very methodical game, a very positional game by both teams. He even called it a thinking man's game. And now the Bruins just need to get hungrier around the net. Brick?
You know, Jack, I appreciate the statisticians that we have that work for the National Hockey League, that work here at the Garden. I don't use the stat sheet a ton, but what jumps out at you when you look at it between periods that I wanted to look at was shots that have missed the net. The Bruins have had some really good scoring chances here this afternoon, but some of their better opportunities, they haven't got it inside the posts. I'm looking for them to make Fleury work a little harder in terms of having to make stops here in the third.
Sagan disrupts the rush. Malkin will regroup in the neutral zone. The game summary brought to you by your New England Ford dealers. And the alert stats crew did not credit Johnny Boychuk with a missed shot when he went intentionally wide in the first period on a 12-angled billiard shot of a pass that came right back to the front of the goal. This puck deflected through the neutrals. It looks as if Ford might have touched that outside the trapezoid and behind the goal line. Be interesting to take another look at that. It was really close. Sagan inside the Boston zone. Of course, if the goalie does touch the puck behind the goal line, outside the trapezoid, it's an automatic delay of game penalty. This is a delayed offside call against the Bruins.
Fans, the Rubens at Tufts Medical Center remind you that Buck
Well, he's pretty active, an outstanding skater. Tough to tell from that angle.
Thank you.
This guy at TD Garden has been really, really good. I'm not sure there are too many other goalies that have numbers like that in this building. Milan Lucic, Cal O'Reilly brings the puck into the zone. It's offside against the pen, so a stop and start opening to the third period here. It's a Pittsburgh team that had rolled off eight straight wins before James Reimer had a terrific game on Wednesday night in Toronto. The back half of a home-and-home set with the pen. Mark drills it through the corners. Puck pops up on Ferris on the far side. Kennedy comes right through that to win the puck. Here's Martin, puck on edge, the tap in front by O'Reilly. He shoves it and Thomas makes another stop. Sullivan looking for Kennedy at the goal mouth. Krejci's there. Krejci bats it down. O'Reilly wins the puck. Sullivan banks it to Martin. Pollock holds in Lucic's face. Now it's Adam McQuaid, but it doesn't connect with Peverly. Martin's shot, leg save, Thomas. O'Reilly to Sullivan. Thomas makes the blocker stop and then takes one right across the mask. And Sullivan says, I'm sorry.
No, there's no sorries in this game. Nice look by Martin from the left point right here. You can see the Bruins all stacked up to take away the shooting lane, but that allows O'Reilly some open space at the top of the crease. Able to get a redirect on the back end, but Thomas able to make the save. That shot again from Martin through traffic. Thomas with the left pad save, but the rebound went right back out in the slot. Sullivan looking for that second chance opportunity.
Now Steve Sullivan, what a career. 15th season. Came back from what a lot of people thought was going to be a career-ending injury. Dupuis drive off. Quarles letting them goes up on the strings. Still loose near the apron. Seidenberg turns it out of the corner. Finds a little space, saucers it. Hamill knocks it down midair, but Pittsburgh has had all of the puck early in the third. Cook into the middle for Jeffrey for Dupuis. A leg save by Thomas. Centering pass, Corvo. Now Cook scores from the crease. Pittsburgh gets its insurance. The Penguins with almost total possession of the puck from the opening drop in the third period, and Matt Cook gives him a 2-0 lead.
Yeah, the focus not there here to start the third period. Inexplicable by Boston. They've just been careless. And that's everybody, not just the five players in front of Thomas, Tim Thomas as well. Some rebounds right back to the front of the net. That's a right pad save that should be smothered or directed away from the front of the goal. And once again, we showed you highlights at the beginning of the broadcast where there were a lot of black jerseys or Bruin jerseys in and around the front of their net. For most of this game, they've done a nice job of protecting the house, but not to start the third period.
Now two goals down against the team that's won 8 out of 9. Pye swings it back to the goal. Thornton puts the body on Niskanen. McQuaid throws it toward goal. Thornton with the pop-up tip splits the uprights. It goes all the way to the end board. Adams through the seam. Ferentz puts the shoulder into Park. Thomas swings the puck far side, but it gets away from Thornton. Adams gets it in deep. Park working the cycle along the kick plate. Ferentz gives him a shove. Vitaly, the centering pass, looking for Adams, but Thornton breaks that up. Getting roundly booed as public address announcer Jim Martin gives the goal announcement.
Goal number 9 of the season for Matt Cook, assisted.
Sagan, the blind backhand pass. Pye finds Campbell. Campbell gains the line. Fires it into Orpik's legs. Orpik puts the shoulder on Campbell. Chara down past the hash marks all the way to the corner into Letang skates. Chara uses the body. Letang whacks at the puck. Sagan tries to get it loose. Sweet short pass from Malkin right in front to Orpik. Boychuk jumps forward. The Bruins get a little bit out of shape. Marchand makes a saving stab inside the Boston zone. Boychuk holds, fires it all the way into the Boston bench.
Twitter users, if you follow Nesson and include hashtag Bruins in your tweets, your post could end up on the air today in the AT&T Twitter feed. Bruins hockey on Nesson. Be part of it.
Dustin Jeffrey and Pascal Dupuis get the assists on Matt Cook's ninth goal of the season at 1:53 of the third period. And the Penguins with a 2-0 lead. One very late in the first and one early in the third. Sullivan shields the puck from Corvo. Brings it all the way back to the blue line. Comes back to the half, forces a one-man cycle. Here's Martin. The wrist shot. A stop and start, and O'Reilly fouls that one off. Corvo. Heels back from Sullivan's pressure. Seidenberg off the corner boards. Marchand kicks the puck loose. O'Reilly turns and snaps it over towards Sullivan. Corvo flips to the boards. Kennedy gets it loose. Bergeron taps off the Boston end boards. The Bruins really having a hard time getting to the red line with possession. Sagan through Bergeron, and McCulloch takes it back. O'Reilly off Sagan's legs. Sagan spins it, but it's past Marchand. And Cook takes it on a pull. Matt Cook. Eli McCulloch. Correction, it's Spinek McCulloch. Get my McCulloch's all mixed up. Fortunately, none of my children ever had McCulloch as babies, which would be a nuisance. A ton of time left, almost 16 minutes remaining on the clock. The Bruins need to do the simple things, as Claude Julien said before the game. Take care of one thing at a time. It's off Ferentz's stick. Krejci stabs it loose. Cook gets a piece of it, and again, the Bruins are in trouble in their own zone. Dupuis fires it into McQuaid's body. Now it's Jeffrey jamming along the board. Dupuis digs it into McQuaid's skates. McQuaid flips it forward, but there's Cook. Puck comes back to the neutral zone. Pittsburgh has had so much of the puck in the third round.
Yeah, and you would expect Boston to really come out and play that dominant third period style of hockey that they've been so famous for this year, but it's Pittsburgh that's just taking it to Boston right now. They've got an aggressive forecheck going. Boston hasn't been able to move the puck quick enough in order to get a rhythm to their offense.
Ferentz looking for Peverly, and the puck is up over the low glass. The Coors Light freeze cam brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light, Brooks Orpik and Daniel Paille. That is a long way for a man to fly. Daniel Paille weighs 200 pounds, and he probably went about 13 or 14 feet through the air and hop right back up. Derek Englund up the boards. Chara taps the Pouliot. It's off Malkin's stick. Boychuk center circle. Kelly now Hamill. Hamill wrists it off the end boards. Fleury plays it. Kelly attacks the puck. Hamill jams down against Niskanen. Hamill wins the puck to Kelly. Kelly to Boychuk. Boychuk along the line. Chara taps past Neal. Down the perimeter to Hamill. Niskanen controls. Leaves it in the corner for Malkin, who comes all the way to the goal line to pick up the puck. Malkin through his own zone. It bounces off the boards. Boychuk has it back at center. Hamill and Kelly have to clear the zone to get onside, and they do. Boston will just take a change. Kunitz softly down the boards. Johnny Boychuk to his lead. Kunitz puts the body on him. Chara has a big collision with Neal. Pittsburgh conscientiously finishing its checks. McCulloch to Chris Kunitz. Off Malkin's skate. Paille knocks the puck loose. Boychuk turns away from Neal. Al Thornton. Cross corner looking for Paille. Adams back after him. They both go past the puck. Campbell the next layer for Boston. Campbell hard down on the puck to keep it moving. Joe Corvo past the hash marks. Past Campbell's stick. Adams takes it, flicks it into the corner. Let's go Bruins, the champ from the TD Garden crowd. This puck deflects up and out of play. The faceoff coming in the Pittsburgh zone when the game resumes. 13:42 to go. Matt Cook has the insurance goal for the Pens. Gentlemen, thank you. The Bruins are working on the longest goalless drought of their season, approaching 120 consecutive minutes. The previous long was 115 minutes, 24 seconds in October, which was a very forgettable month for Boston. Thanks to Heidi Holland and the Bruins staff for coming up with all the answers to our very unpredictable questions. Corvo's wrist shot scores! Whammy! Lindor, and it just worked on Fleury, didn't it? Don't figure.
Well, keep working your magic as you're still down by one, but the Bruins finally find the back of the net. Nice little exchange down low. Marchand, Bergeron protect the puck. Use your points, a five-man offense. Shot, net front presence. Get the shots through. Corvo lets it go, little wrist shot. Marchand locked in a battle, and McCulloch in front of the net. Fleury never sees it. Top shelf over the glove, the Bruins within one.
For Joe Corvo, his first goal in 22 games. And the Bruins are right back in it with 13 to go. Adam McQuaid back, hammers it around through the corner. Here's Benoit Pouliot. Pouliot spoons the backhand to Kelly. Kelly runs into traffic, but keeps his body going toward the puck. It's hang around the boards. Ferentz takes it, sends it in deep. Pass Pouliot, gets under Lucic's backhand. Lucic in the corner, brings it back to McQuaid. McQuaid wrists it back around. Ferentz jumps down to the point. Kelly rotates back. Kelly, unopposed, holds the puck, fakes the shot, brings it to McQuaid. McQuaid wrists it toward goal. It's off a stick. Pouliot gets to it before Orpik can. Orpik gives Pouliot a couple of chucks. Kelly goes in support and wins the puck to Lucic. Lucic with possession, and we're going to get a penalty ruled here. What is the call here? A hand pass?
No, it's a penalty. It's going to be on Pouliot.
High sticking, I guess.
Bruins had good puck possession. Little lineup tweak by Claude Julien. He has Kelly out there between Lucic and Pouliot. Little exchange between Orpik and Pouliot. Pouliot just grabs the stick of Orpik in that one-on-one battle. Is that the call that they're making?
I saw Orpik reaching to his face, so I don't know if it, yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Just about. Did
roll the replay a little further, and you can see the high sticking penalty on Pouliot.
Just about did a nose job on it. Zdeno Chara fires the puck the length of the ice. Campbell on the faceoff win. He and Paille are the opening pair of penalty-killing forwards for Claude Julien. And the Bruins, having worked their way back into this game, have to have an airtight penalty kill here. This is offside, and the faceoff back to the neutral zone. Bergeron and Marchand get the assists on Joe Corvo's third of the season to cut it to 2-1. Let's go Bruins, the chant from the faithful at TD Garden. Pittsburgh has had two power plays and has eight shots on goal. Boychuk with a 150-foot skipper. Steve Sullivan tosses the puck into the corner. Kelly back after with Neal on his back. Chara takes a swipe at it. Now here's Malkin at the hash marks. Boychuk knocks the puck down, clears to the line. They say Letang kept it on the paint. Letang with the puck on edge, fires it around through the corner. Chara picks it up against Neal. Neal puts the body on him. Kunitz takes the puck. It's off of Peverly's body. Comes right toward Thomas, and he puts the trapper down on it.
A pretty good battle by Johnny Boychuk. He made the right play, went hard for the puck, won the one-on-one battle, saw the open lane, and he fired it. But Letang, able to come all the way across from that right side to the left side to keep the puck in.
Malkin, Neal, and Kunitz. Bergeron wins the faceoff, and Ferentz makes the clear. Past the halfway point of the penalty kill to the Bruins. Campbell disrupts the pass from Sullivan to Letang. But Letang brings it forward. Neal has an open lane on McQuaid's side. Neal puts the body out on the save by Thomas. Classic James Neal. Now Neal knocks down the attempt to clear through the corner. Neal turns it back to Letang. Pulls it off the boards with Sullivan. Going down to the top of the circle. Here's Malkin, dangerous high slot. Across the slot. McQuaid gets a stick on it. Paille makes the clear. Paille takes the tang down. He's going to go for a trip here. Kunitz poked away by Ferentz. 5-on-3 for 25 seconds.
I don't think so, Jack. I think they're going to call a penalty. No, I think it was a roughing in response to the trip by Paille.
Oh, okay.
Did they call closing the hand on the stick? Is that what he called?
No, I think he signaled roughing.
Well, we'll take a look at it anyway. There's the tripping call right there against Paille. And I don't see anything by Letang, but he's going to go to the box too.
I'm guessing on sportsmanlike there. I don't know.
Maybe pick the puck up off the ice. We'll see if we can get a look at it. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. That would be closing your hand on the puck.
Yeah, well, that was the motion by the referee. That's why I thought it was grabbing the stick, but obviously he didn't grab the stick up high, but he did grab the puck.
Well, that is a major break because already shorthanded, there is no further reduction in manpower, so it stays 5-on-4. And the Bruins will probably take the Letang-Kaye exchange. Cook angles it toward the middle. Bergeron sends the puck off the boards and out. Pouliot is out of the box. And it returns to even strength. One shot on goal during the unsuccessful power play by the Pens. 9 power play shots for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, now get the momentum back on your side. You had the big goal by Corvo. The untimely penalty by Pouliot, but you get the kill. Now get that momentum back.
Chara hammers it, and it just pinballs off a couple of players. Bergeron goes back to the Boston bench in pain.
Yeah, he was one of the players that puck pinballed off of.
Mark long the attacking line. Richard Clark steers the puck through the corner. Ferentz goes to the end boards with Pascal Dupuis. Tyler Seguin into Milan Lucic, who skates. Lucic at the center circle out of Ferentz. Ferentz trying to go around McCulloch. McCulloch keeps it on the perimeter. Centering pass will be Jeffrey there. Pouliot stabs it away from Orpik, who thought he had a free skate out of the zone. Good aggression by Pouliot on the forecheck. The bank pass comes all the way back into the Boston zone. McQuaid with Dupuis pestering him. Off Pouliot's skate, Kelly catches it on the forehand. Char to McQuaid. Off the stick of Craig Adams. McQuaid. Under Chara's stick as he was looking up ice for a pass. Flips it forward to Lucic. Adams finishes his check. Lucic end over end of the corner. Campbell bumps McCulloch. Vitali around the boards. Thornton is there. Kennedy barrels into Thornton. The puck loose. Vitali swivels it to Kennedy. Kennedy works toward Chara. Bounces the puck down into the corner. Gets underneath Chara. Tries to center. It's off a stick. Thornton turns it back, but it's off of Vitali's check. Thornton finds Corvo working left side against Englund. The centering pass. Campbell saved by Fleury. Fleury with the save of the game. Snapping out the left pad. Adams offside at the line as Englund just about tears his legs apart. Marc-Andre Fleury with 8.5 minutes to go in the game makes this beauty of a stop to keep the Pens in front.
Face the Sabres in Buffalo on the NBC Sports Network. Tune into Nesson at 7 for WBBA and Bruins Face Off Live. Jameson Coyle and Barry Peterson will set you up for the drop of the puck and bring you all the latest news in the NHL hat trick. All that and more Wednesday at 7.
8.5 to go. Brick, as an NHL veteran, I'm sure you're on teams that had long periods of struggles. The Bruins sense an opportunity to get back in it. Marchand takes a huge hit from Orpik on the end boards to try to make the centering pass. Malkin working his way all the way down to the corner. Boychuk bangs Malkin. The Bruins look for transition, but Orpik has the puck. Marchand back to the Boston bench and caved in at the end of the bench in pain.
You know, after that save by Fleury right before we went to break, there was a rebound there, and Hamill was right on top of him. He got laid out by Vitali just before he had a chance to raise it into the upper half of the net.
Close enough. Kunitz, Neal, the low angle shot, produces the rebound. Kunitz follows it. Kelly hits him. Neal, the hard backhand. The referee skates slow it down for Kelly. It bounces over Boychuk's forehand. Chara has Lucic up the left wing, tries to pull through the seam. Cook hoists it back into the Boston zone. Jeffrey and Chara after the puck. Boychuk taps it forward, pass Cook to Pouliot. Pouliot off of Dupuis' legs. Kelly finds the puck. Kelly goes deep against Martin. Martin steers Kelly into the end boards. Lucic around the boards for Ferentz. Ferentz wrists it toward the middle off McCulloch to the corner boards. Now Corvo. Corvo with the hash marks. Tries to swivel it inside. Martin knocks him down. Pouliot tries to tap through Cook. Ferentz with Dupuis in his face. Off Dupuis' stick. Cook bats the backhand into the zone. Dupuis tags up to get onside. Corville steps in front of Rich Peverly and then backhands it softly to the corner. David Krejci in against Niskanen. O'Reilly stabs the puck loose. Tyler Kennedy. Up the right wing, Steve Sullivan has the jump through the seam, no icing. Hyatt leaves it in the corner. Corville around for Ferentz. Ferentz gives it up the boards for Peverly. Off the half boards, it's Neal to Kennedy, the drive, and Thomas makes the save.
A quick turnover by Boston leads to that shot from the tough angle, but nice stop by Thomas. Here's a look at that rebound chance. Looks like Hamill's going to get to it. He has the upper half of the net, even though Fleury's moving across, taking away the lower half. Speaking about taking away lower halves, Orpik closes in on Marchand. He got that little spin move, and even though Orpik pinned him to the wall, still nearly made a play to the high slot.
We're scanning the Boston bench and not seeing Dennis Seidenberg down there right now. Sean Thornton with a jump against Orpik, and Thornton keeps his legs moving and gets to the puck. Letang plays it through the corner to Adams. Adams on the half wall. Paye, it squirts through Vitali's skates. And Orpik has an open side. Bouncer gets past Chara. Clark in the corner puts the shift on. Chara tries to angle it. Clark sets the edges. Now Adams comes back the other way with Chara hitting Clark. Letang's one-timer. A blocker saved by Thomas, and Chara has it. Off the glass, Adams gloves it down at center. Chara with 5.5 to go in the game. Thornton. High in pursuit, Vitali gets there first. Letang swings it under Orpik's reach. Cross ice pass, Sagan gets a piece of it to keep it in the attacking zone. Ferentz waits for the Bruins to clear and doesn't wait quite long enough. 5:07 left. The Bruins have gotten themselves back in it. They got to get it tied in a hurry. Malkin takes the feed from Chris Kunitz off the James Neal shot, and it's a 1-0 lead. That holds up through the second into the third. It's Matt Cook in the crease, hammering it home as Pittsburgh had possession for almost all of the first 2 minutes of the final period. Then Joe Corvo through the screen of Brad Marchand in front. A very physical game. And now we come to the final 5 minutes of it. Brick, what's it going to take for the Bruins to tie this thing up?
Well, they need to make one more play than Pittsburgh does. They got to dig deep, understand what's in front of them, and know how important that they take some kind of points out of this game is.
Marchand is playing dinged up after a huge Orpik hit, but there he is, the Boychuk, the blast, a save by Fleury, and he gloves it. Bergeron had gotten position in front, but Fleury manages to control the rebound away from Bergeron.
Yeah, nice use of the points, too. Nifty little play, free that puck up, good support by Bergeron. They 2-on-1 McCulloch. Now you can get back to the points, and there's the drive. Bergeron trying to get to the front of the net. He makes the decision, instead of just standing in Fleury, he's going to, in front of Fleury, move as the puck's coming, look for the redirect.
Dustin Jeffrey and Bergeron on the faceoff. It pops up and Letang finds it first. Wrists it around through the corner. Chara fights through the stick lift of Dupuis and sends it back in deep. Fleury paddles it to Letang. Sagan on the forecheck. Chara pinches down, knocks the puck loose away from Dupuis. Sagan from his knees into the middle, but there's Matt Cook. Cook sees Boychuk coming and flips the puck to the end board. It's icing.
Anything can happen at Foxwoods, North America's largest resort casino. Go for the slots, table games, or keno, then stay for a variety of award-winning dining options, amazing entertainment, and events.
Both of these teams are outstanding in the third period. We see Dennis Seidenberg returning to the Boston bench. Wonder if he had to spend 15 minutes in the quiet room. Between period intermissions are 17 minutes long. Well, maybe it's that or something else. We'll try to follow up. So stay with us for post-game coverage on Nest. Corvo flips the backhand forward to the red line to David Krejci. Now Lucic makes his way toward the end boards against Letang. Lucic wins the puck to Krejci. The shot saved by Fleury. The rebound to the circle, and Chara sends it to the corner. Kelly spins away from Dustin Jeffrey. Kelly reverses. Letang picks it up. Lucic bumps him. Krejci comes in support. Lucic on the end boards. Turns to the front. The shot deflects and goes over the top and hits the glass. Letang up the boards. Dupuis can't hammer it past Chara. Cook does get it past Lucic to the Boston zone.
Counterattack while they're changing.
And they do. Krejci takes a big hit from Orpik. James Neal back to take the puck.
Yeah, Bruins needed a change as well. Krejci was on an island.
Thornton comes all the way across the ice to interfere with Niskanen's clear. Seidenberg leaves it for McQuaid. Paye, McQuaid. Malkin, a good read, getting past Campbell. Seidenberg off the boards into Paye's body in front of Neal. Now Campbell in a bit of a traffic jam. Seidenberg controls McQuaid to the red line. Hard around into the zone. It gets past Fleury. Far side Campbell gets it past Englund. Paye can't seal it in on the end boards. Thornton absorbs the Niskanen hit. Niskanen has Thornton totally wrapped up. Malkin, the back pass to Englund out of the zone looking for Neal, but Campbell has it. Now Seidenberg, under 3 minutes to go. Johnny Boychuk to Dennis Seidenberg. Malkin, the front man for Pittsburgh. Seidenberg fires him right on Fleury. A little bit of deception there. Looked as if he was going to go around the boards and suddenly turned it toward goal. And that one goes up into the netting.
That's his spot.
Hey, it's worked a couple of times, hasn't it?
If you're wondering what was wrong with Seidenberg, you can see a little markings on his face there. Is the drive, the misdirection. Pretend you're going to go with that hard wrap around and then drive it towards the goal, but Fleury wasn't cheating.
Bergeron wins the faceoff from Jeffrey. Ferentz, Coxon fires. It's right into Marchand's legs, and Martin throws Marchand down, and he gets up hurting for the second time in the third period. Sagan flips the puck forward. Marchand in traffic. Mark whacks it back center circle. Corvo, a collision with Ferentz. Little Keystone Cops here. Corvo with his head down goes to the Boston bench in a lot of pain. Martin's shot can't pick the stick side high corner on Thomas. Boychuk taps the backhand into space. Sagan flying forward with 2 minutes to go. Bounces it, juggles it all the way through. Saved by Fleury, and it's underneath. Tyler Sagan with the one-man rush going through four defenders and almost getting it through Fleury.
Looked like Cal O'Reilly, Jeffrey on the back check along with Mahalik. He's just going to just keep his feet moving, hopes that puck stays with him. He's able to drag it with that left skate back to the stick blade. Almost slipped it right under Fleury. A little incidental contact between teammates. Ferentz, Corvo, right in the neutral zone. Stick ran up high, body contact high. Corvo went right to the runway.
Krejci wins the faceoff. Ferentz to Boychuk. And he hits it off the heel of the blade. Krejci scoots it up to the half boards. Ferentz fakes the shot, now drives it. That's up high on Orpik, who had the stick drop down as if he was a second goalie out in front of Fleury, and Fleury gets a little tap on the fanny to say thanks for making that block. Pittsburgh ices it with 1:43 to go.
Pretty good play by Andy Ferentz at the left point. A little fake shot. That allows the shot blocking forward to move out of the way, and then the lane opens up. But Orpik was right at the top of the crease with his goaltender Fleury to help make that stop.
Shots are 27-27. Boychuk throws it on Fleury, makes the save. Incidentally, Joe Corvo has returned to the Boston bench. Minute and a half to go. This pass does not connect, and it could be icing against the Bruins. Orpik taking his time as the Pens want to bleed every second off the clock that they can. So a big defensive zone faceoff coming for the Boston Bruins here with a chance to pull Tim Thomas if they get clean possession.
Yeah, important to get this faceoff. Obviously, it's in your own zone, so you want puck possession. But then you need that clean breakout. Somebody stretch the neutral zone, open up some space, and get Thomas to the bench.
Kelly wins it, and here comes Krejci, but Kunitz slows it down. Malkin, Boychuk with the hit. Thomas back of his own goal, around through the corner. Chara ahead, Marchand kicks it loose. But it comes to Neal. Neal puts the wiggle on. The shot saved by Thomas. Only a minute and five to go in this game. Bergeron trying to stab it loose in the big line for Pittsburgh out there, holding the puck in the attacking zone. Final minute of play. James Neal around to the end boards. Chara holds it, banks it. Looks as if Bergeron wanted a line change. Some miscommunication from Boston. But Thomas is stuck in his goals. We tip toward three quarters of a minute to go. Johnny Boychuk carefully out of the Boston end. Thomas makes his break to the Boston bench. The Bruins' goal is empty for the extra skater. Orpik gets the puck to Neal. He clears it to the Boston line. Seidenberg across to Chara with 35 seconds to go in the game. Bounces it down the slot. Orpik leaves it. Marchand shot. Lost. Saved by Fleury. Chara's one-timer goes off the leg and it comes back to the neutral zone. Seidenberg fires it in deep. It'll be about 15 seconds to go when the Bruins tag up and get toward the puck. Letang banks it looking for Cook. He can't get it through Seidenberg. Gonna take a miracle rush for the Bruins with the goalie pulled. Here's Marchand over the line. Neal takes it away, banks it forward to Malkin. Malkin looking for the empty net and he misses. 3 seconds to go in the game. Chara gets the icing touch with 1.8 to go. A timeout coming and it's gonna take a remarkable turn of events here for the Bruins not to drop another one.
Oh, what an opportunity for Brad Marchand. A mishandle of the puck by Brooks Orpik on a little kind of fanned in, dump in. Marchand got a piece of it. That put a little spin on the puck. Orpik can't handle it. But this is why you pay the goalies. That is a nice reaction. Right pad kick by Fleury. The overhead. Not sure if that puck was inside that post or not. But Fleury, well positioned. Right leg extended. Kick save. Preserves the 2-1 lead.
Well, a lot of fans heading for the exits. And it has been a tremendously physical and entertaining hockey game. We have seen players from both sides skate to their benches in pain, and some have to go down the tunnels. Just what you expect from two of the top teams in the Eastern Conference, and both will travel and play tomorrow afternoon.
And when you're drawing up plays here with under 2 seconds to go, you basically try to set up one play, but then you plan, you game plan for if the puck doesn't go where you want. So you try to set up two potential shots within these 2 seconds. And that's what the Bruins are going to try to do. Sagan with Kelly, the left shot. Sagan, the right shot, the top of the circle. And Seidenberg, the left shot on the opposite side.
Four men in the middle for Pittsburgh. It's a stalemate. The puck goes to the boards. Sagan drives it into the pile, and it doesn't get through. Pittsburgh, on the strength of Marc-Andre Fleury's work, gives their goalie his 28th victory of the season and makes it 9 out of 10 with a hard-fought 2-1 win over the Bruins in Boston.
Well, the Bruins came into this afternoon's game with a goal in mind to play better and stronger defense in their own zone. Outside of maybe the first 5 minutes of that third period, Jack, where it was kind of inexplicable the way they came out. But I thought overall, in terms of a 60-minute effort, pretty good by Boston. The structure back. They ran into Fleury when they did have opportunities, but that power play, 4 minutes of power play, could have been a difference in this hockey game. Pittsburgh gets a power play goal, they win by a goal.
Yep, and a 58-minute effort, the first two of the third lacking for Boston. Could have been a contributing factor to the final score as well. 30 more minutes of hockey coverage on the way. Dale Arnold has what's coming up with Ace Ticket, Bruins Overtime Live. Dale?